Your kind is weak. You have already lost this war.
Hello everyone, and welcome back for another episode of Monday Night Gaming. In the last episode, we started walking along the Azkaban Road, and we found a clue that would have taken us back to the Hidden Path if we hadn't already done that. Matrix has leveled up to level 50, and I am so close myself, so we're about to head on.
Anyway, for the moment, you're just one segment away from...
So close! Yourself, aren't you? So close!
And something then I died over here, and I don't think we'd been this way.
No, this definitely wasn't me.
Who's killing things? Seriously. Grobles and the mammoth tools.
I can't get through this. Bam, blocked wave. I'm right clicking on everything in sight and it's all dying before I can actually teleport. Right, here we go.
Sorry, do you want me to kill things slower?
No, it wasn't really you, it was more them, but it's fine, it's all fine.
You know what, while you're doing that, I'm going to assign my skills. So, now that I've actually got everything up, I'm thinking I'm going to put a throwaway point into Sir. Just for a bit of extra boss DPI. Oh, I kind of run out of slots though for things.
You don't need extra boss DPI because I can just...
DPS, not DPI.
Yeah, whatever. I was in the middle of combat. Because I take off such large percentages in quick swars, you're better off at going for mob thinning stuff, I'd say.
Yeah, well, Morta would certainly do that.
Those guys are quite good at guns, by the way.
Where? Show them to me. That's not a gun.
Well, the ones that I killed.
So they couldn't have been that good at guns then.
I had to to and fro a bit to make sure that I was properly bouncing at them.
Dodge and weave.
If you can dodge a bullet, you can dodge a ball. Wait, what?
Oh, Aether Blaze, hello.
Yeah, that's the one that we saw from up top. I walked up to him and he died. That's how terrifying I am.
Man, there's so much stuff here.
This is why I'm only picking up green stuff now. It's
I still need money.
It's an efficiency thing. Having said, I'm about half full of green things. And I don't mean salad.
No, you mean a courgette.
Wouldn't that count as, like, salad?
No.
But you could have a courgette salad.
Ew. Oh.
Or not. You could have just said no. Are you serious? You wouldn't have a courgette salad?
No. Blah, blah, blah. Says the vegetarian, I should point out.
Yeah. Oh, there's boxes up top along with a cannon that I want to break, but they're so far away.
Oh, this is for Icon.
Yeah. Yeah, I already walked up to the door and I was like, oh, cool. But I didn't want to spoil the surprise. Were you surprised? You sounded surprised.
Well, I'm surprised at how close it is. I thought it was further away from the map.
That's Vigil neophytes. All of them getting smacked upside the head. See, they could have these cannons.
They already have these cannons.
I think these guys have got something other to say about that. Anyone in this room? Sort of.
Cool. I see a hidden spoils down there.
Cool.
Come here and see it.
Alright, let me just do that yet. Finish diplomacying my way through this situation. Sorry, everything died before you threw your grenade. Oh. Oh, now how the... Alright, so under there. So down and through that valley bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, seeing as we're heading that way, it'd be kind of rude not to, wouldn't it?
Oh, now I'm level 50. I wonder if that means that we can start getting
you can start getting very, very cool stuff.
Well, I don't know if it takes like the host's level.
I've had level 50 items drop, but I think that you can't have your own legendary things drop until you're level 50.
Fair enough.
I could be wrong, but I've not had one drop yet, so.
Well, neither have I, so that doesn't prove anything.
Well, you're just unlucky. I mean, you've been level 50 for, what, half a minute?
How's that?
Might need to work on resistances just a little bit.
Nah.
Oh, there's...
Just need to work on your micromanagement.
There's iron bits up here. Thank you for reminding me. I just reloaded my mana. I do love dual wielding. It's very satisfying walking up to someone and going...
Yes, especially with guns at range. You've been gone an awfully long time.
I was just thinking, whereabouts are you? And I can see you down there. I just saw someone fall over with a bullet. I'm up here. Hi.
Hi, I can't see you because my cat. Oh, wait, hang on. There it goes. Yeah, move back again. Come back along the edge. A little bit further, a little bit further, a little bit further. There we go. Hello, I can just see you now. Hi.
Hi.
What are you doing up there?
Killing things. What are you doing down there?
Killing things that are already dead.
Wow, I actually just did 10,000 in one hit. Not just like a dual wield swing thing, because normally it adds the two up. That was pretty epic. Oh, there's a lot of green glow down there. Oh, that's just reanimators and stuff.
Oh, have I got that to the core too?
Let's say no, and you could be surprised.
Hey, Carmen's chosen. What's up, buddies?
They are actually our buddies, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Yeah. Just checking. This place is big. Also, I think I'm accidentally going up.
Sorry. See you in the sky. I can go down further, but I'm not going to.
Right, there we go.
Found more death's visual.
Hello. Hey. How's it going? Oh, there's a green thing. And I don't mean courgette salad. So yeah, I've been round there. I'm now going round this secondary level.
Yeah.
This place is huge.
Yeah, I'm just running around picking up stuff. Oh, that looks interesting. Oh, that's the thing I could have gone down and through, but I decided not to. Wow, you had a very boring time up here, didn't you?
Oh no, I did kill something. I'm good. My dude just got stuck. Stop being stuck. There we go.
You left boxes.
Really? That doesn't sound like me.
And chests.
What? Are you sure you're where I was?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because I'm... And a hidden spoils chest. Fucking hell.
I'm going to come back around, but I was rushing to get down to you.
I just put my rift down for you.
All right, hang on. Here I come.
I don't know you've been up here because there's loot up here. And also in this corner when you're done over there.
Oh, I didn't actually... No, I didn't go through that bit. I didn't go up there at all.
Well, there was loot up there.
Yeah, that wasn't me. Because I was running along the base finding you. So yeah, this entire corner bit was not explored. I'll head back to my rift and carry on downstairs. I say downstairs,
Hey, I'm back at the cannons, right.
I found a tank.
Nice.
Yeah, it's not letting me do my Shatterstrike. Oh, that's because it's Kaiman's chosen.
Why can't I kill my friend? Why can't I kill my friend? Oh.
Seriously, it's a problem. What's a guy to do? You get so used to killing everyone, and then all of a sudden you can't, and then you got to talk about your problems, and jeez.
Don't remember ever talking about my problems.
They tell you to stop sleeping with a knife under your pillow? Alright, I think I've fully explored except one tiny bit, which is just over here. Oh, there's a pretty awesome banner right here.
Yeah, did that.
Do, 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 do. There we go. Are you shooting the Kaiman's Chosen? I wouldn't blame
you. No. Nah, this is like ether things.
Alright, I need 17,000 experience before the next level. Got it.
That's an odd little side hill.
Yeah. I was looking at it thinking, is there a way past this?
Oh, pretty bridge.
Very nice.
Nice waterfall and stuff as well.
Just looking off the edge for secrets.
A person!
In fact, this looks like it should be accessible down there. On both sides. Oh yeah, that Black Legion dude does not look very well.
Which one?
The guy that we can see on our map.
Oh, up the hill? Oh, yeah. Sorry, I zoomed in quite a bit, so I couldn't even see him.
Look at mending. More tonics of mending. Good.
Or scrap. And yeah, I see what you mean about those the downstairsy bits.
He's sort of moving his hand on the floor.
Alright, you talk to him, I'm gonna scout.
Don't go in there! The Ethereals have torn open a rift! More are pouring through! Will you be alright? Once things calm down, I'm sure someone will come for me. Don't worry. The Legion takes care of its own.
Is that it? Is that all he had to say?
That's all he had to say, just don't go in there.
Alright, I'm gonna take his advice, and I'm going to sell junk back at Homestead. Be right back. Dum dum. You, merchant, buy all of my monster shit. And yes, I do mean that literally.
Yeah.
Alright, no. Definitely no, definitely no. Possible? Probably not. Say no. No. No, no, no. No, 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 no. 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 That will do. Coming back.
There's nothing in here.
Really?
I mean, there's some dead bodies on the floor.
He said there was a rift torn open.
Well, there's a rift over there. I haven't been over to it yet. There's Fort Icon Prison up this way. Oh, and there's a quartermaster and Black Legion Wares and Captain Reeve and a whole bunch of other stuff. And Inquisitor Creed is up there as well. Black Legion Myrmidons. Should we approach this rift?
In a minute.
We're going to do the edge, okay.
Well, they seem all very cozy around the rift.
Yeah, this extends up and across. What's down this way?
Ah, training dummies.
Nope. Yeah, I think Fort Icon's going to be a proper home.
Okay, alright. Do you want to come back here?
Proper home away from home. I'll be there in just a moment. I'm just having a little nosy up here.
Oh, come up and round as well.
Yeah.
And balls.
It just leads to Inquisitor Creed, so you're going to head back. So you went all the way back to sell your stuff, and you could have sold it here.
Yep, could have done.
I'm just a little bit faster than you. Run, run, run. I got stuck.
Yeah, it's just a shame that I'm just a little bit more competent than you.
You realise you're running towards the rift. The rift gate is swarming with ethereals. Ugh. The one that normally puts up the reflective shield, I killed him before he even got a chance. Oh, there's a big named one. Diplomacy! Cool,
Aether Blade again? Fuck off! Go away!
Well, that went okay.
So, we got both Festerellis and Aether Blade there.
Mark of Dreeg. Alright, well, let's go and go up these stairs.
What's this way in? The prison. Yeah.
So there's Captain Reeve there. We've got Praetorian's report. We've got Black Legion scouting report. No, I'm going to pick up both of these.
Fine, I'll talk to Inquisitor. Awesome. Good. You've arrived. Things here are in worse shape than I thought. What happened? Betrayal, sabotage, call it what you will. We've been attacked from within. The Ethereals have gotten a hold of the commander. He's been possessed? Precisely. Based on the reports, Commander Lucius has been sending our men out on futile missions, thinning out the fort's defenses. Then, once the watch was sufficiently weak, he opened the gates, allowing the Ethereals to pour in. He was not counting on human ingenuity, however. Weapons Master Edric collapsed the front gates with some explosives, cutting off the enemy's forces. When we arrived with reinforcements from the south, the coward Lucius fled into the armory. Until those gates are cleared, we're stuck here. I need you to enter the armory and recover what's left of the heavy explosive and use them to clear the rubble. But beware of Lucius. He has shed his human disguise in favor of a monstrous form which I cannot even begin to describe. You will likely have to deal with him to get to the explosives. It will be done.
Cool. I just gained level, so I'm now level 50.
Bring him back here.
Congratulations.
Come see what's left of my ware.
Let's have a talk to the quartermaster. Not enough reputation for that. Of course. Okay, so let's have a look at these greens that I've picked up. That's a no.
No, not enough reputation for anything to do with the Black Legion yet.
Right, I'm going to change over those boots. That increases my damage. Required physique 617 to wear those. Wow. Oh,
did you say 617?
Yes.
I have enough physique.
What? I've got admittedly more cunning, but yeah, that's the 55% extra physical damage hulking leg guards.
Nice.
I might start putting some points in physique.
Yes. Well, like I recommended, like one in physique, one in something else. For you, probably cunning. For me, it's going in spirit.
Yeah, I've been doing...
I will talk with Weapons Master Edric while we're here as well.
Sure thing.
As you can probably guess, the fort's seen better days. It's going to take every able-bodied man and woman to bring Fort Icon back to its former glory. Care to lend a hand? Sure, what do you need? I need someone capable to enter the armory and recover what's left of our scrap and building materials. The supplies were originally designated for Homestead, but with the recent attacks, we can't afford to spare any resources. After Lucius opened the gates and the Ethereals started pouring through, I had no choice but to collapse our own gates with explosives. The repairs will take weeks, but we can't get started without those supplies. Unfortunately, the possessed commander has fled into the armory, perhaps to finish sabotaging what's left of our arsenal. I hear you are experienced with dealing with Ethereals, so I was hoping you could look into this matter. I will recover the supplies. Now, why can't I just give him some of the 326 scrap I have?
Yeah.
Is it the wrong sort of scrap? Is he really that fussy?
Of course it's the wrong sort of scrap. Now, this is difficult. So, if I change it over to the Pendant of the Royal Crown and the Jewel of the Royal Crown, my damage goes down, but it's probably only temporary because I'm losing plus one to all skills.
Also, it's worth pointing out that the damage per hit is not necessarily accurate. I've seen lots of discussion on various forums that you should pretty much just ignore the like damage per second details and just try and work it out almost by hand.
Good to know, good to know.
Like, damage per hit is fairly accurate when it's broken down on the per strike basis. It's just when you factor in all the other effects, they don't get factored in.
Yeah, okay, well, let's have a look here if I put those back. Yeah, it does make a big difference. I lose about 10% damage per second, but that's assuming I'm constantly attacking, which I'm not, because I tend to burst damage, so it's hard to say. But it is going to be worth it once I get the other part of this royalty set. Let's see what else I've got. That's no, that's no, that's no, that's no. Let's put those in there for now. What? That can't be placed in my item transfer. Oh, because it's one that I bought. Yeah.
Oh, is it soulbound?
Yeah. Okay, well, let's put it in there for now, because I can always deconstruct it later. I'm going to read these reports. So, the Praetorian's report. The air reeks of sulfur and smoke. It is difficult to breathe as I write this report. We have been ambushed, facing overwhelming odds. Some kind of ethereal monstrosity has risen from the earth up ahead and is spreading ether fire wherever it passes. I've never seen anything like it. The captain ordered us to punch through the opposition and take out that horrific thing, but he was killed in the initial attack that claimed most of our equipment and troops. The men panicked and we were forced to retreat. I managed to rally the few that were left, but it had become abundantly clear that we would not survive this. I pulled the battalion back to the entrance and ordered a full retreat to Fort Icon. With the ethereals fast approaching, there was not much time to consider our options. I had the quartermaster hand me what was left of our explosive charges. We rigged the tunnel entrance and set them off, effectively sealing the mountain pass and the ethereals in with it. I regret to report that with the Twin Falls Bridge destroyed and the tunnel sealed, we are now effectively blocked off from the south, but I take solace in knowing that the immolation we witnessed will not spread beyond the mountain crags. Praetorian Marcus Edin.
Cool, well, I found the tunnel that they sealed off.
Cool. I'm going to read the Necropolis Scouting Report as well. Commander Lucius ordered the scouting mission to the north. When I asked what we should be looking for, he almost lost his temper and said anything that might cause a disturbance. His reaction seemed rather out of place and strange. The commander is not known for such outbursts. It also struck me odd the way he used the word disturbance. I took my scouting squad through the north gate and almost immediately started seeing some ethereal activity. We changed our course and headed for the hills rather than travelling the main road. It took longer, but we avoided a large number of ethereal dead. They appear to be gathering in the north in preparation for an attack. Their numbers have swelled tremendously since my last mission outside the walls. The return trip is going to prove difficult. I sent one of my scouts back to report this information immediately. Heading north, we passed by the necropolis. From the mountaintop, we did not see anything unusual. Searching as far as we could on our resources, we discovered nothing but the accursed blood cultists everywhere. Avoiding them made our progress slow. We did see one strange thing of note. The cultists appeared to be collecting blood in vast quantities and hauling them in wagons filled with large glass cisterns. We followed for a bit to see where they were being taken, but were spotted and forced to retreat. First Regimental Scouts of Black Legion, Sergeant Metius Castellan.
Yeah, the Bloodsworn really love their blood. By the wagon load.
Cool. Safe storage, no questions. Alright, let's put that in there. Let's put that I'm just sorting out my stash very quickly, seeing as we're right here by it.
I've just realised I can actually afford that writ from the rovers, so I'm going to go pick that up.
Oh, nice. Concentrated rackings, cracked lodestone to replace the one that I used, vicious jawbone because you can never have too many, Ark of Dreeg, scavenged plating.
Go. That's Devil's Crossing, Homestead, and the Rovers, all with bonus rep now.
Oh, look at you. I've got everything except for Devil's Crossing, but they're not massive fans of mine at the moment. I'm sure they will be in the future.
I'll keep an eye on this.
Okay, right, so...
prepare yourself.
Let's have a look at what the different vendors have got. Okay. Ooh. That will actually somehow increase my damage.
What are you excited by?
I can't... oh yeah, I can shift-click on it. Yeah, so... it's going to increase my damage... either by 11 or 275, and I'm trying to see why. I think because... no, it's got less armor-piercing than the current things. Maybe it's just because it's got...
base damage?
No.
36 to 94?
50 to 83. And it's slower. Oh, probably because of the plus to physical damage and plus to attack speed on it. That'd be it.
Yeah, the attack speed will make a huge difference.
Yeah, which is why you can't necessarily trust the damage per second when you're doing, like... single shot explosion.
Yeah, you definitely
things.
Can't trust the damage per second difference Iron that's shown well on the things. Spent. Even if you're holding the control key to try and take off any of the augments or components you've added, still does not give you a good rendition.
Still, very Iron interesting well at least. I think what I really need is two giant, massive arm-piercing weapons, which is pretty much what I was going for anyway. I've got 61% bleeding resistance and 80% piercing resistance. Basically, I am a piercing counter-piercer.
What happens if you come up against yourself? Dink, dink,
dink, dink, dink,
dink, dink, dink, dink.
It's basically, it'll be like Venice with fencing foils.
Ah, we can't go in here yet.
Really? Sealed by the Black Legion. Didn't they just send us in here? Oh no, they sent us out there.
Yeah. Well, they haven't even sent us out here, really. They kind of have.
Slay Commander Lucius.
Out here, if you could just ignore all these dead bodies that are decomposing. this is the heavy explosive site. And then the way we need to go is over here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so it actually takes heavy explosives rather than just more dynamite.
Yeah, so if I bring you up here, you can sort of scout the area a bit. That's where I'm about to show you the scouting report for. But that's fine. Who needs scouts?
Apparently I don't. Oh, there's a dog. Ooh. Camladris, the Rhymeheart.
Yeah.
Do you want to... yeah, I was going to say get someone's attention. Oh, I don't have my stamp anymore. Oh, that's going to be weird. I might need to reorganize my skills. Okay, right. What am I going to do instead? Empowered piercing aura? What?
You put a bigger piercer spike, didn't you?
I can have both on at the same time! Oh, that's so cool. Okay, so yeah, that's now diplomacy. So the button that I've been pushing for diplomacy and saying diplomacy is now actually diplomacy.
Just killed the Hulk.
Yeah, I kind of like jumped in there too, you know. Just saying.
So you're busy diplomacying your diplomacy bar.
It's important to properly negotiate, but... oh, I'm dead chuffed about that extra piercing aura. That's an additional 75% piercing damage. Which is basically a buttload. Oh my god, right, so guess how much my Shadow Strike goes up to now?
20,000.
Very close. 18. It's actually 17.7, but given it was 15 before, that's a pretty big boost. So you going up there and I'm going up here, okay. Hidden spoils.
Yeah, I just got regular unhidden spoils.
Well, these weren't particularly hidden. Oh, I can see Faldrak.
You've gone up to that scouting bit that I was trying to take you to.
Oh, scrap! This is worth me coming up here.
Yeah, so I was trying to bring you up here so we could see all of that down there.
Well, that's kind of cool. So I think we're heading into that other bit over there, aren't we?
Oh, I believe you're right.
Oh my god, look at how far down it goes. What the hell fell through here?
That's a tank. There's another tank there. I think I see a third tank.
That just looks like a bonfire down the middle.
Oh yeah. No, if I zoom out again, I can see more tanks further down.
It doesn't look like any major like fire demon or anything. I'm just going to stick my face in the port entrance. Right, or Icon Armory, that's where we are. Hello. Oh, that was a little bit pointy. Let's try that again.
Were you just trying to grab that dynamite?
No, I didn't even see that there was dynamite in here.
Of course not.
Yep, it would be definitely interesting to play this again with a different style of character.
Yeah. I'd be interested in how a soldier type plays.
I'm bannering. Yeah, I suspect soldiers would be much the same as I'm doing at the moment. Although, you can play someone that can basically become immune to damage.
Hey, there's the supplies. Let's grab those and take those back. I found Edric's back scratcher.
Oh, cool. I'm going to get that dynamite.
Given that we're about to take these supplies back to Edric, I find that quite amusing.
Legion supplies. Not bad for a dagger. That's pretty good poison, actually.
Ooh, we can deliver these supplies to either the Black Legion or Homestead.
Oh. Well, Homestead already kind of like us enough.
You want to give them to the Black Legion?
I think so.
Well, I'll leave it in your hands.
I want the Legion to love me. But I did see a chest around here that I want to open. Yellow thing. Never gets old.
Come on, let's get turn this in.
Okay. We'll just kill these last guys and then we'll get out of here. Diplomacy! Which is actually diplomacy rather than me just stamping. And nothing in this room. No secrets either. Back out we go.
So you're going to the Black Legion then?
Yeah.
Hey Edric, I found your back scratcher.
Oh, and while we were there... Is it that much closer? I suppose it is.
Made it. Yes, yes, it is that much closer.
I'll be there in a moment. Even though I did spend a bit of time looking at the map, it's at least 20 seconds closer doing that.
I'll give you a good price on what I've got left.
Hey, Adric. Yeah, here's your supplies. Ah, oh, excellent. I was afraid they'd been destroyed after the recent explosions down in the armory. Thank you for recovering the supplies. Here, take some of this scrap. I'm sure you could use it too. So, we get 500 Black Legion rep, minus 250 Homestead rep. Get 5 scrap, I assume that is. And...
oh, I think I have to do it myself so I could go to Homestead.
Okay.
If I wanted. I'm not going to. I'm going to stick with the same thing you did.
I'll keep your stash safe.
Yeah.
Just put these bits away.
Yay, bigger inventory bag. Nice.
Oh, cool. I didn't even notice that.
Come see what's left of my wares.
And those onto there. Nice. Stay with me. Promise. All right, well.
Likewise, dump stuff in here. And then I shall read this compilation of Fort Icon reports. After the explosion that destroyed the armory, I went back over this past week's reports and compiled this collection of excerpts, which I found to be relevant. They are pulled together and arranged in order that the events took place.
Explosions hurt.
I do this in hopes that it will illuminate how this has happened and raise questions of what might be done to avoid future attacks like this. That is assuming we survive. Captain Frederick Bucknell. Report 1. Report from the North Wall. Night Watch. While patrolling the upper wall, I witnessed a soldier enter the armory. I would not make note of it, except that he appeared to have been looking around to make sure none could see him as he entered the gated door. The torches were out in the area of the courtyard, so it's impossible for me to say who it was. Report 2. Report from the officer of the watch. Several men have gone missing, and we suspect that they have deserted. A complete search of the fort and surrounding areas has ended with no sign of them, however. The scouts have found no sign of tracks and have concluded that the men never left the fort. Report 3. Report from the Master of Arms. I have discovered 10 small casks and 5 large casks of black powder missing. It is difficult to account for the missing supplies since only 5 people in the entire fort have access to the keys that would open the black powder storage. Commander Lucius is headed the search himself after receiving the worrying report, starting from the bottom levels all the way to the top of the towers. Nothing has been found. Ominous.
Yeah. I've just dropped my rift down, but I think I figured out why there's that big hole in the armory.
Oh yes, why is that?
The big, massive explosion.
Oh, right. Yes. Yeah. Well, that would certainly do it. Fine, I'll come through to yours. Ah, some scrap. Ah, some scrap.
2 bits of scrap already. God damn.
No, it was more like a scrap, like a little fight. Oh.
It's funny because it's language humor. Out. Yeah. I really want to kill Ethoran the plague dude. Can't reach him. Right, we've got to find a way into that secret room. Found it. Oh, and some scrap.
Dynamite for me.
Well, I killed him, but I fumbled a couple of times in that, and that was a little bit embarrassing.
Your face is embarrassing.
room, loot everything. Cool, I think that's all in there. I mean, the diplomacy skill is good. I'm glad that I have it. Don't get me wrong. It is gonna be weird when I lose it. I miss my stamp.
Or scrap. Seems to be getting a lot of scrap from these guys.
Maybe it knows you're scrap deprived. The lack of being able to stamp, though, is certainly keeping my mana levels higher. Nothing from the actual scrap pile. That's quite a nasty, or was quite a nasty, reflective mage. And then I waited until it wore off, and I stabbed him, and he died very quickly. Yeah, once that reflective shield of theirs wears off, they die so easy.
Alright, I just have to go AFK for a minute. I should be back shortly.
That's okay.
Back to the four icon.
Well, Matrix is gone. I'm just going to explore this little bit. I'm not going to go through the iron gate, though. That looks like it definitely moves on somewhere else. Stairs up. So we're going to head back to roughly where he was and see if we can finish out that last bit of the map. That should be relatively safe to do, I'd say. And not only that, it's keeping this entire area clear. And we can have a look around for secrets as well. Ooh, I say relatively safe. Relatively is one of those words where... I'm not going to get myself in trouble. Not going to get myself in trouble, he says, and then immediately nearly dies. Let's just pop this. And then we can focus on picking them off. Diplomacy going. There we go. That's the big one that I was worried about. And the others, they can die as they go. There we go. Flesh warped pauldrons of ruin. I don't know if we deserve those. I think we deserve something much better, because that was pretty epic as far as fights go. Let's just plow on into this last room, and I think that is it for this section. So we may have to go up to that iron gate. How are we doing for inventory space? We've got an absolute ton left. More mobs spawning in. Put the hurt on them very quickly. There we go. Yeah, so if we can get one more devotion point, that's going to make a huge difference to our damage, just because of the extra armor piercing we're going to get from that. Very much looking forward to it. Let's open the door. Get on the floor.
There we go. Locked.
No, it's now locked. So, important to know. Let's put this down. We can head back to where Matrix was. Ah, right. There's Commander Lucius. So, I'm going to head back to Fort Icon.
I have returned. Okay, sorry, right. One of my cats was just yowling around the place.
Oh, dear. Right, so I've gone through an iron gate and I can't get back.
Wow.
Actually, no, I could step through my rift to you. Which would bring me back. But Lucius is on this side with me. He hasn't spotted me yet.
I'm just following in the trail of destruction.
Hi.
Ah. Yes, I see a problem. There you are.
Thank you.
So, did you want to kill these, yes? I've got a report I can read first, if you'd like.
Let's hear your report, but I'm going to step away from those bodies.
Armory explosion! This is my final report on the massive explosion that has destroyed the North Courtyard. It is intended to be read with the compiled notes pulled together from the past week. With the intent of establishing a damage report and a death toll, I assembled a squad of soldiers and led them into the shattered depths below Fort Icon. The explosion appears to have blown down into the sewers, making the smell in the armory ungodly. That, in and of itself, has made it almost impossible. The plumes of smoke reduced our vision and choked the air. Crumbling walls, supports, and floors were in constant danger of additional collapse. The explosion appears to have been centered on a single large support below the armory. At the bottom of the devastation, we found several dead men charred almost beyond recognition. They appear to be the men who went missing earlier this week. My investigation indicates that the missing men were using the stolen black powder to make an opening in the sewers to make their escape. In closing of this report, I'd like to raise two concerns. First is, one of the men was an explosives expert and should have been aware of the destructive potential of so much powder. By itself, I wouldn't give this detail a second thought, if not for my second concern. Another of the men has been with the Black Legion for nearly 8 years with no sign of dissent or disagreement with command. In fact, he was due for a promotion to a commanding position soon. Something doesn't fit here, you know? The tale that is painted indicates sabotage from within, but who would go to such lengths to frame these men? Without more information, I cannot say with certainty what's going on, but my gut tells me there is more at play here than at first appears. Captain Frederick Bucknell.
It's Lucius, let's go kill him. Alright, Malfoy, I've got... Whoa, he's big. He's immune to diplomacy.
I just Man, he really loves me.
Stepped away so I could do my teleport stab. There we go. Teleport stab got him. Legion heavy explosives, dynamite, untitled letter, and demonic assault chainmail, which sounds awesome but requires more physique than, well, I have. Let's read this untitled letter. I successfully infiltrated the fort as you commanded. It's so ironic that the commander of this garrison is one of the weakest minds I have ever encountered. There's so much turmoil and fear that resides within him, he was easy to manipulate and overwhelm. While I do have full control of his body, there is something in this region that tampers with direct communication, something tainted and ancient. Anything capable of such an act demands further investigation. I write this correspondence in the meantime, so that another may look into this matter. Fort Icon has proven to be a challenge for us, and now I understand why. The vast stores of weapons and war machines the humans have amassed is staggering. It's a wonder that they've not exterminated themselves in their endless pursuit of warfare and self-destruction. Nevertheless, everything moves according to our grand plans. I've already taken steps to sabotage their armory and planted evidence leading to several deserters. Nobody suspects my involvement. But the main reason I have deemed it necessary to report to you comes from a most unexpected discovery. The anomaly, the revealer of secrets, walks among these humans and even now shares with them our plans. We've since adjusted our projections in this region, ensuring that anything the anomaly reveals is of no use to the humans. But its knowledge of our ways could still prove detrimental to our success on this world. For now, I've begun sowing the seeds of distrust about the anomaly to the humans. Their fear is so great that they had it moved to the prison where it remains. Once my sabotage is complete and the gates are open, Fort Icon will fall. Then we can deal with the traitorous fitting of such unprecedented betrayal.
I wonder if they're referring to us.
Oh, no, it's something in the prison that's been moved that we couldn't get into the prison.
Oh, the other prison, yes.
Yeah, not just, like, your life, prisoners as it is. Well,
no, I meant, like, Devil's Crossing.
Oh, right. Oh, the other prison, okay.
Yes. Well, anyway, I think that's probably enough for this episode. So thank you very much for watching, everyone. And join us again next time, where we shall continue into the depths of the armory.
See you soon.